mighty Melissa McMorrow is a very, very talented boxing champion. This is her when she's fighting. And this is her when she's talking to us. How are you feeling today, first of all?
Good. Feel great.
So tell us the big news you have.
Well, so we're looking to, you know, fight with Zanford Promotions on a big card coming up. So we're really looking to push that and hoping that something comes through, you know. But
who's your favorite fighter right now in the world?
Favorite fighter in the world? Jackie Nama.
Why?
I mean, we have very similar styles, so I do, like, watch what she does a lot and I study what she does so I can.
You obviously, when you spar, you not only spar women, you also spar men. What's that like?
Yeah. To be honest, you know, I spar smaller men. I'm a flyweight. It's 112 pounds, so I usually don't spar any men that are over 130 pounds. And so I find it to be, it's good work. Sometimes the females don't have as much stamina, so the men really kind of give me the best work, and I think that, you know, I can compete really well. My team looks out for me and makes sure that I don't get in over my head, so, you know.
Your weight class, Chocolatito, what do you think about him?
I think he's great. I've studied him as well. You know, he has a really good, he comes with a leading foot, so he can really get a lot of power on stuff, so I've been studying that, and I'm working on that, so that I can be like Chocolatito.
What makes you good as a fighter? Is it the jab, the intelligence, the power, the relentless? What is it?
I'm a relentless fighter.
Do you keep coming and coming? You're like a Mexican fighter.
Yes, I'm a short fighter, so I have to come in. I have to be close to you. So I'm relentless. I throw a lot of punches. I'm a very interesting fighter to watch. This year I got voted as the most entertaining fighter of 2015. So I like to be into my fans. It's about the fans. So
how did you get into boxing, though?
Someone brought me to a sparring event. I had a great time. I thought, oh, I could go with this. I wanted to compete right away. I'm competitive. I want to win. And I thought I could win. I said, oh, there's people here. I could beat them.
And how many fights did it take you to become a champion?
I had an amateur career. I fought 20 fights in the amateurs. At that time, it was difficult to get fights. So 20 fights was a lot at the time. As a pro, I think I had maybe 15 pro fights before I fought my first time.
Holly Holm, Ronda Rousey, did you see that knockout? What did you make of it? And
you know, I talked to people before the fight.
To who?
They were outside of boxing, so he was actually a painter.
Okay.
But I was talking to this painter that knows Ronda Rousey. He had painted Ronda Rousey a number of times. And so I was saying, he asked me, who do you think will win that fight? I said, you know what's the toss-up? Ronda Rousey, she has very good ground game and stuff, and I don't know enough about that to be able to analyze. But I said, if she tries to box her, Holly Holm will whoop her. Because, you know, Ronda Rousey had been coming out with all this, like, oh, she's a great boxer, But nothing compares to 40 fights and multiple world championships. You can't compare with that. That's like putting Mayweather in with, like, someone that just started and saying, oh, the other person might win with their hands. No.
Did they ever have a rematch?
I think Holm will take it. I just don't think Rousey, it takes a long time to develop your boxing game. Like, she can't develop her boxing game in a year or whatever enough to compete.
All right, tell everyone where to follow you on Instagram or Twitter.
So Instagram at Mighty Melissa M. That's Twitter. It's both, actually. Instagram and Twitter at Mighty Melissa M.
There you have it. Stay tuned. VSUSReport.com and Melissa back reporting. That was good, really.